Howdy. My name is Phillip Payne. I'm a sculptor from Scottsdale, Arizona. The title of this piece is Visions of an Iron Horse. I did this to depict Geronimo coming across the first set of train tracks he ever saw. I just thought to myself, can you imagine seeing a train for the very first time, maybe not even having heard rumor of them before? It was just such a moment in history. The United States finished the Southern Pacific Line of the Railroad in 1883, and Geronimo didn't surrender till 1886. And so you can imagine being forced into surrender and being taken by train, as he was, all the way to Florida, where he lived as a prisoner of war for many, many years. And all of that when, you know, this was his land, his territory, and he had witnessed the massacre and slaughter of many of his family members throughout time. And so I really wanted to do a composition that pulled us into that moment. Of course, it could have happened in many different ways. This is my artistic interpretation of it. However, I did want to put in some details into this piece that I'm really proud of. All the way down to the gun belt, this is actually modeled after the exact gun belt that Geronimo was wearing when he surrendered in 1886. It really gives us kind of a sense of the history, though, the detail, the elements of Geronimo that were very showmanship-based, which was a big part of Apache culture. They were big on the stories and on their medicine, and Geronimo especially was an amazing storyteller and was very good at kind of sharing his view of what he had accomplished. This is one other kind of fun detail from when I was in sixth grade. So I wrote this May 30th, 1999. So Geronimo's been a fascination of mine for a long time. There's a part right here that I wanted to read to you. And it's just talking about the history of Apaches in general in this time period. It says, and his name then was Gokule. Like every Apache male had been drilled from boyhood in the cardinal virtues of cunning and toughness, the twin sources of his people's strength. Trickery was considered more useful than pure courage. Therefore, a raider who could quietly make off with a few horses from someone's ranch was more esteemed than someone who made a bigger haul but at a greater loss in the process. And that's an interesting element that was very different about the Apaches versus the cavalry, where the goal was the thing and the amount of sacrifice sometimes neglected completely. For the Apaches, to lose one man in a raid was a big deal. As a boy, Gokule was forced to stay awake for long periods of time to learn how to deal with exhaustion. He trained as a long-distance runner to traverse a four-mile course through rough country, carrying a mouthful of water without swallowing or spitting it out. And so this level of training that Geronimo went through, and especially on foot, even more so than on horse, he could cover up to 90 miles in a day, it said. So in 24 hours, he could go 90 miles. The Apache were known very well for, if you were to come across them and you were on a horse and you only had the one horse, they would be able to outdistance the horse and catch up with you. So this was a people of toughness, a people of great strength and great tenacity. And really that was one of the things I admired most about Geronimo, was just that level of tenacity. I feel like it's a quality that we all need in today's environment, though we can apply it in a more modern way, looking for these elements of strength. And are we all surprised sometimes by what's coming at us? We don't see it coming. You know, in a year like this, it's about the tenacity. It's about digging down and finding our strength and using that strength to move us and our families forward. The composition on this piece also went through a number of evolutions. When I first started, I had the concept of Geronimo discovering a train for the first time, or the tracks. And at first, he's just kind of there, and he's got a gun, and he's looking at a train track, and it just had the single track, a very simple piece. And the train tracks were flat, and it was kind of a really important piece in my evolution as an artist to really open myself up to getting away from that, I know exactly what it's going to look like at the beginning, and to really falling in love with the process of art and the art of creation. And so then I added a horse, and everything was still flat and very rough, and then I started adding the drama. In this case, had to make some changes. The tracks on this, a lot of people feel like these are a lot bigger than train tracks should be. Some people realize that they're smaller. There would be about 56 inches from 56.5 inches from track to track in reality. And if you take a horse head's length, which is about 26 inches, you start to put things into scale and you start really realizing that the way the eye looks at things and the way the eye sees things in the different scales that we sculpt in, you have to kind of play with it. You have to let go of making it perfect and make it creatively. Even the grade on this, I did for the drama. I did this so that when people see the piece, they get this sense of building emotion and rising tension. And even other little things like the tilt of the horse's head. I feel compositionally, this is one of the best pieces I've ever created, just because from every angle, and it you just get wonderful circles. The piece always leading back into itself, which was a thing that Michelangelo was wonderful at, always having lines that led back. Little touches like the tail coming here, and instead of just leading out of the piece, leading back into this, and then designing the rock to pull the eye back here, all the way into decisions of where you crop. You know, like, do you want to have each of these railroad ties be complete and all the way out? Or do you want to be artistic with it and have these lines kind of each catching and leading back into the piece to keep the focus where you want it to be artistically? So a really important piece in my career and in the things that it taught me. And I feel like it's a wonderful representation of a period in time and a period in history that really only ever happened once and could only ever happen one time. And I thank you again to all my collectors and the people who've been into the gallery to see this piece all over the world. Thank you for sharing the love of this history, the love of the story, and the love of art with me. And we'll see you again soon.